So who needs IPFS? Well, not me, because I prefer IPFS way, which is immutable data, right? No one wants to change the data. But if we ever wanted to change the data, we could do the following, which is going to be IPNS naming system, right? So let's say we're the space pirate captain, right? And then we need to keep track of which planet we're going to pillage next. So we're going to start with Moon, but we actually need to change the state. So Moon has this hash, and then Saturn has this hash. So what do? If we want to keep track of the state, so we start with generating public key and private key pair, and then we with that. So that's going to identify this specific record, for example, where to go for pillaging next, right? And then we generate the IPNS record. And the key thing that it is going to have is going to have the public key, right? So that we could identify that this is for where to go next, right? Then it's going to have the value, which is going to be, first is going to be the Moon, and then it's going to have the sequence number, and the sequence number would help us keep track on whether like this, which record comes after which. Right, but it's not going to have the reference to the previous IPFS record, unlike the blockchain stuff. And then the key thing is it's going to have the crypto signature that's for this public key, right? And so we would be able to tell that this is actually issued by the guy who has this private key. Okay, well that's cool so far, but now the amazing thing is the pirate would be able to change its state and issue the new IPFS record, which is going to have the same public key, right? Because it's the same resource, the same thing, but it's going to have the new value of the Saturn, and it's going to have higher sequence number, and it's going to have the new signature. And this way the space pirates would be able to pillage and ravage the Saturn. Yay!